Hey guys, you're going to love this story. Imagine for a moment you found a property in Southern California. I'm going to call this video Diamonds in Your Backyard. Get it, diamonds. I could have said gold, but you get the point, right? And here we are. Oh, look, just while I'm talking to you, no caller ID. Let's see what they have to say here. Hello, Diamond Consulting Group.
To accept, press 1. To send a voicemail, press 2.
Hello, Diamond Consulting Group. This is Claude. How may I help you? That's the, let me check. Yes, you are.
Hi, sir. How are you doing today?
I am wonderful. Who do I have the pleasure of speaking with?
Michael Stevens.
Hi, Michael. What can I do for you?
Hi. I was just going for your channel about advertising a game mighty quick.
Say that again, please. I didn't understand you. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Can you hear me clearly?
Yeah. What did you say before?
I was watching your ad about, and I was wondering what is it about, because
I don't know.
I didn't catch the
what ad? You're gonna have to help me a little.
Like the money ad?
I don't know. Money ad. What do you mean?
Like on your channel, like.
Like on my what? Cow.
Like on your channel.
Channel. Okay.
Yeah.
Money ad on my. I don't know what money I. On my channel, money ad on my channel. I give away free books and things on my channel.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Well, why don't you just say it?
Because I get confused and I didn't know it was a money ad, but it was a book ad. Sorry about that, because I get confused and I was trying to call you to see what.
Oh, okay. About. Which book do you have? I've written a lot of books. I think, how many, let me ask, my 9 books, 10 books? Yeah, I've written a lot of books, Michael. Which one do you need? Neither do I. We got a problem. What do you think? What is the thing you want to change in your life? What's the one thing you want to improve on?
Something about thinking about my future, about becoming a businessman.
Just become a. What do you do right now?
I'm a caretaker at a local church.
Sounds good. Oh, that's wonderful. Doing God's work, helping people, probably getting good money. What's wrong with that?
Jesus is our savior, that we converted to Christianity, which we do in North Dakota in our local church.
Fargo is lovely in February, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah.
Fargo in February. tell me what So what do you need help with exactly? If we had to fix one thing, what would it be? More money?
We need like donations, like.
You're not going to get it. Oh, okay. Then just keep asking the flock.
Excuse me?
Just keep asking your flock if you need more money.
Okay, well.
Congregants.
We're asking for donations. With what?
Okay, I can't help you with donations, really. That's, you know, I donate. I helped build a theater in Colorado, and I donate to the Lions Club and Father Joe's in San Diego. And I think do we Make-A-Wish Foundation. I'm looking at my wife right now. What else? And everything like that. But you don't want a donation from me, do you?
I'm looking forward to, but I'm really busy running a business. I'm just taking a call, 15-minute call, just to confirm you.
When you say confirm me, I'm not understanding the point of our conversation.
We're like a busy church here, like getting anyone to donate to our church, like for the charity.
Okay, what would you like from me, though, Michael? Before we run out of time here.
I would like to make it like a donation. Like $1,000.
I don't need a donation. I don't need a donation. I'm already wealthy. Thank you, though. Give it to someone who deserves it.
Okay, well, it shouldn't matter because we're making a donation to the church. I mean, is that what you're good for?
I don't understand what you're talking about. You're going to have to help me here.
Well,
It sounded like you wanted to give me a donation, but I'm already a millionaire. So you give it to somebody, give it to somebody in Fargo who needs it. Okay. We were talking at the same time here. It's annoying as hell, isn't it? When we both talk at the same time, you take a breath while you have to take a breath and let me finish my question, answer to you first. Okay. See how annoying it is. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. No, you're nothing. You're just a crazy guy calling me up on the phone and I'm having fun with you. And he hung up. And this is what happens while I was doing this video. These are the wacky guys who call you. You know what I always say? Practice. Okay, and this went way too long, but I knew I was recording. And I love when they call me while I'm doing a video with you guys. And the thing about it is, you get people who call you. You know you're not going to do business. I knew this guy was a whack job, okay? So the thing, it's a New York term of expression. It's not one of endearment, by the way. It's the thing about it is, when you get somebody like this, practice. I'm always saying, how do you get good at sales, persuasion, influence? How do you talk to people, have honest? See, when you're dealing with people honestly and upfront, you're asking the questions, and you must have heard, the takeaway from this video is, I think I said at least, I'm looking at my wife here, at least five times, I don't know, or can you help me, like that, yeah. And everything like that. Just, I play feign ignorance. In other words,
he wasn't making it clear.
He was wacky. He was crazy or something like that. So you either get a sale, you get a quick no. And if you know you're dealing with a crazy person, get a lesson or have some fun. If you're talking to a manipulative salesperson, okay, just have some fun with it. And the great thing about it is I had a laugh. I had fun. I honed my skills. And now I've got a great recording to share with you wonderful people, because nobody, even on these super long videos, deserve success more than you good people. Have a great day. Go to my webpage, ClaudeDiamond.com. Get a free book, schedule a free consultation, and you have a great day. Bye-bye.